views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
The truth is funny. With Colette Stephan, we'll have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network as she provides energetic shifts and consistent results in every area of life, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success. Many people who shift out of limiting beliefs roar with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. The truth is funny. Shift happens. Feel instant relief. Stay tuned for more fun and release struggle and suffering. And now, here's your host, Colette Stephan.
Good morning. This is Colette Marie Stephan. Welcome to The Truth is Funny on Transformation Talk Radio. Stay tuned for the next hour and experience the instant relief of tuning into your intuition. Shift happens every Wednesday morning at 8 o'clock a.m. Pacific Time, live on the radio waves and in the archives at thetruthisfunny.com and transformationtalkradio.com. The energetic shifts are still accessible through what I call HSN, the Higher Self Network, if you are listening later. So I've been traveling around the globe and meeting some really interesting people and sharing inclusive information with you to provide you with an opportunity to here's some different ideas, and also to call into this radio show and receive energetic shifts and creative solutions to your problems with my favorite energy practitioners. And we love to hear from you, so feel free to call in 1-800-930-2819. On today's show, I have a new guest, William Hatch. And Will was born and raised on a cattle and grain operation in the farming hamlet of Wandering River, Alberta, Canada. He learned the value of hard work from his father, who worked as a plant operator while managing the family farm, and the value of service from his mother, who volunteered for the school ambulance and fire department. At the age of five, Will fell in love with NASA and was determined to build the first school in space. The inadequacies of formal education encroached heavily on his dreams and continued to have a negative influence throughout his school years. He consoled himself by communing with nature in the forest throughout most of his childhood until his interest in rockets, audio, and RC cars inspired him to attend the University of Alberta to earn his bachelor's degree in electrical engineering. And then after the birth of his son, Will invested half a year working in the earthworks construction industry of Fort McMurray to support his family while finishing school. He worked as an engineer in Calgary's oil and gas industry for 3 years. And while developing innovative engineering software algorithms in his spare time, at the age of 28, deeply disillusioned with trying to satisfy the conflicting demands imposed by society and frustrated by the current political arena, he chose to walk away from that industry and explore his potential as a human being. He started climbing mountains for fun and began applying that energy to everyday challenges. Will is now determined to deliver a powerful democracy through the development of a system that will effectively expand each citizen's circle of influence to the whole country and give a clear voice to voters, allowing them to interact and cooperate with each other and the government to explore creative solutions to what is happening in the country of Canada and also as a global citizen around the world. Are you there, Will?
I am. Good morning.
Welcome to The Truth is Funny.
Thank you.
So, you know, you are really interested in the value of communication. And we decided that for this radio show that you wanted to talk about, you know, what people create with their energy. Because energy, yeah, go ahead.
Yes. We have all sorts of energy. Everybody does. So what are we going to do with it? And that's just a matter that I find to be an issue of awareness. And I want to help everybody bring awareness to what it is that they're doing.
Yes, that is a good plan. And I know, like you've been talking, like because in Canada right now we're moving into an election, and across the globe right now there's a lot of problems that people are having, and a lot of it is through what you feel is a lack of purposeful communication. And so I know, like you've been, going to, just tell us a little bit about your journey. You said that you spent a lot of time in the forest when you were young. What was going on there for you?
Well, I grew up out on a small farm on the edge of Crown Land, lots of space to go out and run and play. And when all the people were very difficult to deal with, I found that the trees weren't. And so I spent an awful lot of time out there. And as I grew up, I watched in the political arena every year, scandal, scandal, scandal. It didn't matter who was in power. So it wasn't very hard for me to recognize it was the system that was the problem. It wasn't the parties. And then I started to take another step back, coming from the farming aspect where we took care of ourselves out there. And I realized that so many people are looking to the government to do something for them without realizing that they're in a democracy, which is government by the people, for the people. And so then it's just a matter of getting everybody to communicate what they want to do so that they can go and do it.
Absolutely. And this is like not just like an issue here in Canada, but a lot of people here are getting ready for the election. And I'm not much of a political arena type person, but I haven't voted. I have to say, I myself kind of gave up on voting quite a while back because I just realized it just seems like they're it doesn't seem to have an effect, but you have this idea of this ability for people to communicate not only with each other effectively, but also with the government, like so that people could actually get together and like-minded people and join forces. So just tell us about that, because I know you're working, first of all, you're working in the oil and gas industry, and you've chosen not to. What happened there?
Well, growing up in the forest and learning to love the trees, I never planned on going into oil and gas. I could see how oil and gas was disturbing everything that I was so in love with. So I took electrical engineering because I figured that's the next thing. Everybody still needs energy. Everybody needs to go places. How are we going to do it after oil and gas? And that's where I was moving. When I went into that discipline of engineering. But now that I've had that mistake behind me and I got to reaffirm why it is that I'm doing what I'm doing and why it is that I made those decisions at such a young age, now I can see how you hit it right on the head that this software platform that I'm dreaming of, it's so simple. All it is you come out, you ask questions, or you make statements, I feel this way. And that's all it is. You're not talking one-on-one with a person. You're talking one-on-one with the mob. And the sense behind that is that it can depersonalize it to the point that it doesn't matter if I don't like the way you dress or I don't like the way you raise your children. If you and I both agree that we want more fresh organic vegetables, then we can all get together and do whatever it is that we need to make that happen. And the beauty of this being not a government thing is that it can stretch across borders.
Awesome. I love purposeful communication, which we'll talk about when we come back from the break. You are listening to The Truth Is Funny on Transformation Talk Radio with Colette Marie Steffen and my guest today, Will Hatch. And when we return, we will share more ways to move energy. Feel free to call in 1-800-930-2819, and let's make some more shift happen.
Solution is my queen, cause she stays strong. Yeah. She is always in my corner, right there when I wanna. All these other girls are tempting.
Hi, I'm Tim Darter.
And I'm Steve Kramer.
Join us on Spirit Fire Radio. Discover how to add the mechanics of meditation to your day.
And watch yourself connect in a whole new way. Find the amazing moments in life's routines that often pass us by. Add to your awareness with Spirit Fire Radio.
Tune in each Wednesday at 9 a.m. for your weekly guide to practical mindfulness. And to learn more, visit www.spiritfireradio.com.
Tired of traditional talk? People pontificating about this or that, the left or the right. Sometimes the truth is just all lost in the noise. Tune in each week to Straight Talk with Chuck Gallagher on TransformationTalkRadio.com, Mondays at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern, as nationally known guests talk about what's important to you, your life, your concerns, and your success. Tune in and turn on to Straight Talk with Chuck Gallagher. Visit ChuckGallagher.com for more information.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
My dream is to end homelessness.
My passion is living a green life.
My dream is to end poverty.
My passion is volunteering.
My passion is making a difference.
My dream is to cure Lyme disease.
My passion is rebuilding communities.
My passion is helping those in need.
My passion is caring for the elderly.
My dream is to find a cure for cancer.
My dream is to leave a better world for my children.
We all have that special passion, that lifelong dream that drives us to live our lives with meaning and to create a better world. No matter what drives you, we can all make an impact. Dr. Pat Basile is helping others make their dreams come true so we can all help make our world a better world.
To learn more about how Dr. Pat is building a community of sharing hope, strength, funds, knowledge, and information, visit abetterworldcrowdfunding.com today. That's abetterworldcrowdfunding.com.
The Women of Wisdom Fall Harvest Festival is coming up right around the corner on October 24th from 10:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. with free admission located at the North Seattle Community College in the Conference Center. Festivities include a silent auction, healers, educational booths, delicious food, and a variety of vendors. You won't want to miss this fun-filled event. For more information, visit womenofwisdom.org and we'll see you there.
When I need motivation, my one solution is my queen, 'cause she's be strong. Yeah, she is always in my corner, right there.
We're back on The Truth Is Funny with Colette Marie Stephan and my guest today, Will Hatch. Before we continue, will you please share your contact information with our listeners so that they can get in connection with you if they choose to?
Sure. My email address is thoughts, thoughts, at thisagree.ca.
And I love that. Did you say disagree? Spell that out.
thisagree.
As opposed to disagree.
Yes. I don't want to be disagreeing. And if anybody wants to try to phone me, area code 403-919-5826. And that is the only way to find me on the Book of Faces.
You were talking about our social media, Facebook there. All right. Well, thank you. And just for the listeners listening in, we are taking calls today. If you want to call in and have some energy cleared, 1-800-930-2819. Just before the break, Will and I were talking about why it's so important for purposeful communication. And because of kind of the political climate in Canada right now, you know, you hear a lot of people saying that they don't trust the government. They don't they complain a lot about what's going on. And, you know, do you want to just talk about that? Like when we complain, we're basically putting a lot of energy into that. What would you suggest we do instead?
I've been down that road. I've complained, and I find that the universe answers your complaints with something to complain about, because you're pouring all of your energy into that which you do not want. And the big ironic joke about this is that it does fall back into purposeful communication, because it's purposeful communication with yourself. And so when we look around us and we see the government is doing things that we don't necessarily like, and we want to get upset about it, we want to complain about it, we want to go and rant that the government needs to do something different instead of the truth, which is, I need to do something different.
Awesome.
We all need to do something different. And so when we pull it back into our domain and we take the responsibility on ourselves, then we can start this dialogue with ourselves of, what am I creating, and does it serve me?
Absolutely. Your energy flows where your thoughts come from. And, you know, I talk about this a lot on the show. We're creating our reality. And our thoughts, like everything around us, everything that we see around us, you know, if you're sitting in a chair right now, that chair was created by a thought someone had about building a chair. So we're always building something, and change is always happening. And this is what I love about your desire for purposeful communication. And, you know, for those of us who are, you know, not so computer savvy, Do you want to just explain to us, like, what a software program could actually do, and why you're excited about, you know, why someone who's a, you know, you're a dad, and you are, you know, you're an electrical engineer, and you were working in the oil and gas industry. It seems kind of like in your spare time, you were working on this software program. It seems like you must have had like a big desire for this, you know, purposeful communication. So just explain this to us, how this could work.
Well, I'm lazy, you see. I don't like to do things the hard way. I've done enough of that already in my life. And so I like software because it's something where I can just set out the set of instructions. Here's the process. Step one, step two, step three, all the way to the end. And then the work is done. I never have to do that work again. I can always go back and call on it to come and do more work for me. And all it costs me is a tiny bit of electricity. So this the software that I'm working on now, this is about your time. I value your time because I value you. And you, if you're going to try to have a one-on-one conversation about what is important to you, you're only able to reach so many people. And the shortcoming of that is that it's so easy to get caught up in what you disagree about in the process, where that doesn't really matter so much. If we both love something, we want to create it, we can do it. So this software is about you not having to have that conversation more than once. You have it once with the mob, and you hear what the mob says. And then you can connect with the people in the mob who feel a specific way about something, and then you can move forward from there. And then once we tie in money on the end of it, so that, for example, if we all want to get cheap medicine, we want to get doctors, we want to buy doctors instead of having to go and spend a whole bunch of money each doctor visit. You know, we want to do it the Costco method and all get together. Well, then we can get the people who are interested together. Of that group, you're going to find a small group of people who have all the knowledge to set up the process and the system and the business that goes behind it, and then present it back to the mob who is interested. And then it's so easy for a million people who agree on something to put in $10. And then what do you do with $10 million? Now, all of a sudden, we can leverage our power together for creation.
That's brilliant. And, you know, it sounds kind of utopian in some ways because people, you know, are a little bit discouraged, I would say, like when I talk to people. And I know, like for you, you've gone through this yourself. I mean, we met a year ago or almost a year ago. And, you know, you've been, as you said, communing with the forest a lot. And, you know, I talk about this a lot on my show, that nature is so important because, you know, when we spend time in nature, we are able to see that there's perfect order in the universe, and it alleviates fear. And, you know, and this is something that as a child that you were really drawn to. I was like that when I was young. I always wanted to be outside. I preferred animals to people, actually. And in some ways still do. you know, just because they're simple and you can learn so much from that. And, you know, it's kind of funny because we met from you listening to this radio show and or through this radio show. And, you know, I have met over the years many people that, you know, and I tell people this all the time. People will say to me, oh, well, you're so intuitive. How did that happen? You must be, you know, have a special gift. Every single one of us is intuitive, and we all do it in our own way. And yes. I have learned this from teaching seminars around the world to different people of different walks of life. That we all are clearing energy intuitively in our own way. And, you know, you are a very brilliant energy practitioner. And I recognize that. And what was funny is at the time, it was when I was in the process of editing my book, and I needed to hand it to someone who had never really gone to a seminar of mine or really had an idea of my work. I wanted to kind of find a guinea pig, someone that was already doing energy work, and then see if you had some, you know, some, I guess, some structure behind that, what it would do for someone that was already doing it and is really intelligent. So what was your experience? Or do I want to ask?
Oh, your book was amazing to read through, and yet it opened my mind to things that I had already been considering. But this affirmation, this confirmation that when I realized that why do we go to sleep? It's because we can't wait to get back to death. That it's not an original idea. This is something that's been floating around the collective consciousness for quite some time, and it just happens to come out through me. And it's beautiful to be able to connect with you and realize that we're on the same journey and we've got many of the same teachers.
Absolutely. And this is like what I love about the work that I do. You know, my colleague Mark Kettenbach and I have been sharing the energetic upgrade seminars, and many of my students over the years are now really stepping into this, and they're finding that they're having a lot of results, of really good results in their life and in their lives of the people around them. And I love that. I just love it. And that's why I do what I do. And that's, you know, why I have the radio show, is I want to share with people this information that we're all capable of intuitively connecting with each other. And I love the idea of then extending that into a way that people can actually connect in the third dimensional plane. I am Colette Marie Steffen, and you are listening to The Truth is Funny on Transformation Talk Radio. You can connect with me at thetruthisfunny.com and on social media, Facebook and Twitter, at The Truth is Funny with Colette. You can call in today if you want an opportunity to shift your life into better, 1-800-930-2819. We'll be right back to make shift happen.
Hey, life, look at me. I can see the real time. Cause when you shook me, took me out of my world, I woke up. Suddenly I just woke up.
Tune in to Sheer Alchemy with Leslie Fontaine on TransformationTalkRadio.com. And get ready to stir up your passions, remove your blocks, and shift into an entirely new existence. Speaker, teacher, channel, clairvoyant, Leslie Fontaine is a transformation catalyst who channels a powerful energy from Source to catapult listeners into living the life they were born to live. Whether it's shifting from scarcity to abundance, from emotional pain into joy, or from illness into health, Leslie will help you step into the true essence and power of all that you are with the help of the Ascended Masters and Archangels. You will not be the same. Visit TransformationTalkRadio.com for show dates and times and LeslieFontaine.com to say yes to explosive abundance.
What if there was no right or wrong way to be a great parent? Join Access Consciousness Facilitator Glenna Rice as she and Dr. Pat invite you to be the questionable parents you truly are and empower you to know and give the awareness required to create ease and joy with your children. Join Dr. Pat and Glenna as they focus on parenting for the modern family. Tune in every month to the Dr. Pat Show on air and online at TransformationTalkRadio.com.
My dream is to end homelessness.
My passion is living a green life.
My dream is to end poverty.
My passion is volunteering.
My passion is making a difference.
My dream is to cure Lyme disease.
My passion is rebuilding communities.
My passion is helping those in need.
My passion is caring for the elderly.
My dream is to find a cure for cancer.
My dream is to leave a better world for my children.
We all have that special passion, that lifelong dream that drives us to live our lives with meaning and to create a better world. No matter what drives you, we can all make an impact. Dr. Pat Basile is helping others make their dreams come true so we can all help make our world a better world.
To learn more about how Dr. Pat is building a community of sharing hope, strength, funds, knowledge, and information, visit abetterworldcrowdfunding.com today. That's abetterworldcrowdfunding.com.
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Tune in each Wednesday at 1 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 Eastern Time on Transformation Talk Radio to Limelight Radio with Katina Macris. This is an inspirational, cutting-edge radio show educating worldwide listeners on a diversity of Lyme disease-related topics. Each week, Katina will interview some of the world's leaders in health, wellness, spirituality, and human potential. For more information, visit LimelightRadio.com.
I am Colette Marie Stephan, and you are listening to The Truth Is Funny. I have Will Hatch here with me today. Feel free to call in if you would like some energy cleared, 1-800-930-2819. Will and I are talking about the power of purposeful communication. And also, we were talking a little bit before the break, and I would just like to have you talk to people a little bit about this, the importance of getting out in nature. I talk about this a lot on my show, and, you know, you're someone that really has done a lot of that. So, you know, you like climbing mountains. You like going into the forest. A lot of places that a lot of people are kind of scared to go. Tell us why it's so great so that we do more of it.
Well, first and foremost, I think nature taught me a great lesson. Let's look at trees, whether a tree drops its leaves or not. Is that for me to judge that one tree is better than the other or lesser than the other? No. And then we look at plants. Plants do all sorts of things, and bugs. Bugs do all sorts of things. And so the lesson about it is just to really get out there and realize that here is nature expressing itself. It doesn't care what you think. It's just there saying, hey, look at me. I'm nature, and I'm doing my thing. And with that comes this absolute peace for me that when I die, I'm going to go into the ground, and I'm going to come back out as a tree, and then I'm going to get eaten by a bird and fly around the world, you know, the little bits and parts of me. And that doesn't really matter. None of it really matters all that much. It's all beautiful, and it's all life. And until we actually get out there and fully express ourselves, we don't even know what we're missing.
Well, what I always, you know, find amusing is, like, you know, when you think about flowers, when they're blooming, they don't compare themselves to the other flowers.
No.
And say, I'm more beautiful than you, or I wish I could be as beautiful as that flower. And that's why, you know, when I was studying with Nisim Haramina at the Resonance Project Foundation, that's one of the most fundamental, important things that I came to a realization about is that nature is fractal, and we can see this in the way, you know, a pine cone is, with the way fern grows, you know, leaves on the tree, the branches on a tree. There's perfect order. There's like, and so for those of us who, you know, we're going back and forth to work, people are driving, they're in their cars a lot, you know, they're in buildings, air-conditioned buildings, and then heated buildings, and, you know, not getting outside into nature. A lot of people are kind of afraid of going into the forest. You know, tell us something that it will inspire us to get out there and experience that more.
All it takes is a little bit of faith. And what happens in that moment is that you become calm. You become relaxed, you're appreciative, because your fear is what's creating the problems. I've been out in the mountains. I've seen grizzly bears. I've seen cougars. They don't care about me. Not very much. They're more afraid of me than I am of them. So when I come out with the attitude of, wow, you're beautiful and I just want to appreciate you, they walk right on by. And if you're afraid of getting out to a cougar to test this, start with a hornet. Hornets are my favorite bug, next to ants, because of how they work in colonies. They're so simple. They've only got a few rules that they really follow, yet somehow in mass they can do all sorts of amazing things. Now, I can be in a swarm of hornets and be unharmed. Well, people out of the swarm of hornets are being stung. And that experiment was a huge part of me coming into the awareness of what I was creating with my energy.
Wow, that's really, like, because when I, years ago, quite a few years ago, I had taken an animal communications course with a woman that Lynn McKenzie, that's well known in that area. And one of the things that she taught me was that animals communicate by flashing pictures, and that we can flash pictures back to them. And you know, it really improved my communication with animals. And also, something that she said that I've always found very interesting is that insects will only bite you where you need energy cleared. And, you know, before that, when I went out, if there was mosquitoes, they were on me. People would be like, good, Colette's here. You know, we're safe from the mosquitoes. And now I know what you're saying, because I can go out and there can be mosquitoes or whatever around and I don't get bitten anymore.
Yeah.
And so a lot of people, the fear that they have around that is that, you know, they're going, you know, that in a way, an insect bite is medicine.
And
And, you know, like the plants and the trees around us, they are medicine. They have a vibration of their own that's very calming. If we allow.
And when I worked in engineering, it just wasn't working. You know, I couldn't fit into the routine. I was struggling with trying to fit in this 5 days on, 2 days off routine when I feel the moon. I binge eat during a full moon, and I fast during a new moon naturally. That's just my cycle. And to try to fit into a week cycle with this company's, it just wasn't working. So when I left, at first I was still struggling, trying to figure out how I'm going to make ends meet in this third dimensional world. And I couldn't do a resume, you know, the simplest thing, write out 12 lines on a resume. And I couldn't do it. So I said, all right, obviously there's something you need to do first. So I spent 6 weeks of doing nothing, intentionally doing nothing, sitting down in a chair, staring at a dust speck on the wall for 10 hours kind of thing. And I started forgetting everything that I thought I knew intentionally. And at the end of the 6 weeks, I had this amazing ego death, out of body experience where I looked down and I saw all of me, not just the parts that I liked. I saw all of me and all of my beauty. And in that moment, that was when my journey really kicked off. And here we are a year later, and wow.
You know what? I speak to so many people from all walks of life, like I said, and, you know, in different countries and different areas. And I love to have people on the show that, you know, are young and have new, fresh ideas and are willing to take the risks that of changing their life, of actually speaking their truth. And, you know, you have a son. And so you know, do you want to just talk about that, about being a father and being in this world and what your wish for your child is and for the other children that he's growing up with?
I realize that as a father, you can provide many things. You can choose to provide a home. You can choose to provide worldly things. You can choose to provide emotional support, or you can choose to provide a very difficult lesson by not being there. And it's really up to you. So when I looked at what did I want to be as a father, I said, you know what, I want to engage this little person, make sure he knows that I'm there for him, and make sure he knows that it's my job to love him and to teach him. It's not my job to make him happy. It's my job to help him grow up, to understand enough about the world to be able to make his own way. And most importantly, it's my job to give him the opportunity to choose.
And I love that. 'Cause we are always choosing.
Yes. And with that, I have a 5-year-old that just amazes me over and over and over again. He knows so much about moving energy that he doesn't even realize he knows. He has been my greatest teacher in all of this.
I love that. I talk about this a lot. I love so many of the children that are being born now. They're very sensitive, and, mm-hmm. you know, evolution has, you know, we're evolving, and the children around us are very sensitive. And this is, you know, really important to me. I have, a student and, you know, colleague now of mine, and Nicole Short. She has been on this show a couple times. And, you know, when I met her 5 years ago, her son had been diagnosed with so many spectrum disorders, and he was in a lot of difficulty, and he's doing so well now. More importantly, she is sharing information that allows other people who have children that have also been diagnosed with these problems, autism and other things, to move forward by intuitively connecting with these children with the idea that these children actually have something for us that we can learn. We have to go to another quick break here. I can't believe the time is going already, but we'll talk a little bit more about this when we come back. This is Colette Marie Stephan with The Truth Is Funny. I'm thrilled to connect with everyone. I'm happy to say that my book is now out in print on Amazon, and you can also get it at lulu.com, and you can also get it directly off my site. It's a compilation of years of experience and insights that I've gathered, connecting with thousands of colleagues, students, demos, participants, radio participants. A word of warning, reading this book may trigger this shift out of you. We'll be right back.
You give me something I can hold on to.
Are you feeling broken from your relationships? Are you second-guessing yourself about friends, family, and lovers? Tune into the hit show that's creating a buzz in the love-seeking community. Love Seeker Radio, finding love for your authentic self with renowned love coach Heather Lynn. Tired of dissatisfying relationships? Kiss them goodbye and power up your love seeker energy. Coach Heather Lynn reminds you that you can just be you, the beautiful and perfect you. Visit heatherlynncoaching.com to learn.
What would you say if I told you that you could change your life in only 1 hour and all while lying down relaxing? Thousands of people all over the world have. What am I talking about? It's called Access Consciousness, the BARS. The BARS is an energetic body process that contains 32 different points on your head that, when run, assist you in releasing decisions about any area of your life that you have made solid and, as a result, cannot change. The BARS is the first class in Access Consciousness, a dynamic set of tools and information designed to transform any area of your life. When you have a BARS session, the worst that can happen is you feel like you had a fantastic massage. The best thing that can happen is your whole life could change. Go to accessconsciousness.com today to find a facilitator to schedule a private session or to find a BARS class in your area. Are you willing to give yourself an hour to change your life?
Tune in to The Truth Is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. This hit show will have you thinking outside the box and riding the wave of infinite potential. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. Visit TheTruthIsFunny.com.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman, as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
You got attitude? Keys to the rescue. Adjust your attitude with Keys Clear Protein Waters. So refreshing. Just a few sips of Keys will give you a whole new outlook, thanks to 22 grams of the happiest protein on earth. Tongue-tingling tasty without the guilt of naughty or nasty ingredients. If that doesn't put a smile on your face, maybe you need to drink too. Put a little woohoo in your attitude with Keys Protein Water. On Amazon or at Keys, K-E-E-S, please.com.
1230 WPLQ.
This is Colette Marie Stephan. You're listening to The Truth Is Funny with my guest today, Will Hatch. And Will, just before we take, we have a caller here. Before we take this call, will you please just share your contact information with people one more time?
Thank you. My email address, thoughts, THOUGHTS, at thisagree.ca. thisagree.ca. And if anybody cares,
I have to say
me,
again that I do love that. Disagree instead of disagree.
Brilliant. You got to get camouflaged in there so that people can accept you before they realize what you are. That's all.
And did you want to share your phone number also?
Sure. Country code 1, area code 403-919-5826. And that is the only way to find me on social media.
Awesome. Okay, well, we have a caller on the line, Julie from Ottawa. We'll just quickly take this call. We don't have a whole lot of time, but we'll see what we can do for you. Julie, are you there?
Hi, this is just a follow-up from last week. I think I spoke with you last week.
Yes.
It's about deadlines and performance anxiety.
Mm-hmm. What's going on now?
I had sort of handed my, kind of did my writing exchange with a friend, I was still souped up on adrenaline for days afterwards. And it was, I crashed maybe days afterwards. But yeah, it's very familiar pattern. So, and I just felt pretty burnt, a little bit burnt out and kind of happy, but burnt out.
Okay, so what is your, you know, are you wanting to, I'm getting that you want to create. So, Will, what are you picking up as the, you know, as
Okay, so I said good, because what comes to me is that all that adrenaline, that is pure, pure energy, right? Your body is recognizing that you have a big job ahead of you, and it's preparing you. It's giving you everything that you need for this job. Now, the problem that I'm seeing is that unless you direct it somewhere, it just sort of sits inside you, and it goes around in circles and circles and circles and circles, and then it leaves you feeling drained. You crash even though you didn't get anything done. Is that about what you're experiencing?
Well, I guess I felt a lot of kind of anxiety and almost that where you're like your mind is going a gazillion different directions, and it wasn't until like I handed my thing in to my friend who's going to do a writing exchange. And so it's low stakes. It should be low stakes. and then I'm still revved up. And
well, it's
like,
you know what, when I'm picking up
it's not, none of this is a big deal. Cause I think I've been trying to take on my creative, sort of energy in a kind of more manageable fashion. And I think you're right. I think it does sort of cycle and I kind of want the next thing, but I'm not sort of biting into the next chunk.
And when you, consider yourself
like
to be like a binary computer, recognize that the central nervous system is the hard drive of your computer. And so we want to just strengthen that for you. Because like what Will was saying about computers is when you have a software program and you know, it takes consistent steps of action. So explain that to us one more time, Will, what that's called.
An algorithm.
Yeah.
My rhythm, I can't dance. So my rhythm is the algorithm. I can look at something and break it down into its little pieces and figure out what makes it tick and what it needs. So if you've got all this energy about something that you're telling me isn't very important, then what do you think the energy is really about? Call it pulls up hard drive and algorithms and programs, because what she's getting at, I think, is that it's pulling up something old or something that hasn't yet happened. And the energy is trying to go into that, but because it's not being directed where it's supposed to go or where you want it to go, now it's got to go somewhere. And so you put it into nothing and then you want to rest. Oh my God, I haven't rested because I've been awake with all this energy and I'm judging that this is off my schedule and it's not good. And so I want to rest, and then you get your rest, right? And it might be not the way that you expected it or the way that you intended it, but it's still what we asked for, is my experience.
And the thing that I have suggested to people is taking consistent steps of action. The universe wants to see consistent steps of action. So you want to establish what the goal is, and then even if it's the smallest step of action, it's really important that I've discovered this, you know, because especially in the writing of the book, it takes a lot to, you know, persevere and get through that experience. And so people are like sometimes overwhelmed by, like, they have a beautiful vision or a huge thought and they're overwhelmed by it. And this is what I love to recognize, is that if we recognize that our central nervous system is like the hard drive of our computer, that we can use that energy and take consistent steps of action, just as Will is explaining in these algorithms, that this is what we can do. And I find that if people breathe life into something every day, it's like if you're growing a beautiful flower and you only water it, you know, you put like 2 hours and you talk to it and you water it and you look after it, but then you forget about it for a week. When you come back, it's not looking so beautiful anymore. And so we just want to strengthen that for everybody, like these, you know, recognizing that we can take consistent steps of action towards our goal, then what we're doing is we're taking that energy and we're efficiently and effectively applying it, kind of almost like a software program, to our hard drive. I didn't think I'd ever talk this much computer talk, Will.
I'm sorry. I've broken you.
So, Julia, how are you feeling right now?
Okay. I think as I was sort of, as you were talking, it's like, but which goal?
Okay.
That's what was coming up for me too, is that what do we do with our kids? You know, we tell our kids that before I'm going to get you a puppy, you have to show me that you can be responsible. So when we go out there and we go, oh, I want it all and I want it all right now, we end up in a very difficult place. Trust me, I've been there. And you got to start off with something small.
Yes.
Whether it's I want to start a blog, if you're a writer, if that's it. I've been considering that one myself. I'm a software writer. I've been thinking about writing stuff that people will actually read.
You know what? We have run out of time, believe it or not. Julia, thank you for calling in. And we're just going to strengthen this for you, because I feel like you do have, you know, we're going to get you strong to defining a goal and moving towards that and proving to yourself. And this is really beautiful, like just taking a small one. When you have success in that, you move on to the next success and the next one. We've run out of time. Thank you so much, Will, for coming on the show. It was really cool. And thank you, Julia, for calling in. Thank you to everyone else listening. Any last word you want to say? You've got about 30 seconds, Will.
Whoever you are, I believe in you. You can do this.
Awesome.
That's about it.
And
if you're stuck and you need that reassurance, I'm here.
All right. Thank you very much, everyone. And we will be back next week on The Truth is Funny, Transformation Talk Radio with Colette Marie Stephan. Bye for now.
You've been listening to The Truth is Funny with Colette Stephan. Tune in to The Truth is Funny with Colette Stephan each Wednesday at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern on TransformationTalkRadio.com. Join Colette on the Higher Self Network as she provides energetic shifts and consistent results in every area of life, inspiring listeners to shine their brilliance and ensure success while roaring with laughter as they recognize the humor of the giant cosmic joke. The truth is funny. Visit thetruthisfunny.com for more information. That's thetruthisfunny.com.